this a problem.
I'm not making anything a problem. Do wrong. Not touch. That'll be assault okay. charge if you touch
no,
my stuff.
Assault is hitting you.
No, it okay. is not. Touching me in any way is assault. And you want to find out, polite, with everybody
why
I've encountered
like
to.
This? Why you show up like
I,
this?
What do you mean? I was getting pictures of a historical building and now I'm being bombarded by y'all.
Because you're videoing us.
How am I supposed to get pictures of a historical building without a camera?
Okay, but you don't need to video us.
You came up to me. I wasn't videoing you.
When it's getting loud, it's a disturbance. Maybe one side or two side, it's still a disturbance.
I wasn't being loud.
Oh. Are you law enforcement or anything?
I'm Chief Deputy of Perry County.
Chief Deputy of Perry County?
That's a sheriff, wouldn't it?
Okay. All right. So. All right, so how much have you had drunk again?
I had about three, maybe four. We bought a bucket.
So who remembers when I went to the Perry County Courthouse and the public workers in the courthouse called the sheriff on me for recording in the courthouse? And then Sheriff Ricky Don Jones, he comes down and educates everybody in there, make sure that they know what I'm doing is completely lawful, what they're doing is wrong, and then even invites me to the sheriff's office afterwards to file complaints on those public workers. Now, he had his chief deputy with him the entire time, Chief Deputy Edwin Johnson, and I could see in his eyes he probably would have arrested me. Had the sheriff not already taken the lead, he probably would have taken their side and made me leave and or arrested me. He was even giving me weird vibes at the sheriff's office. But all that being said, they did the right thing. They may even be two of the best cops I've came across in my career. Maybe even top 10, unfortunately. But guess who just got arrested? First, let's watch a little clip from when I visited the Perry County Courthouse. Then we'll get into the arrest video. Check it out.
It's the Perry County Courthouse in Perryville. The internets say this was built in 1888 with $4,000. Do you know who this is of?
I don't.
No. Mm-mm. Hey, this sign over here that says employees only, is that for the stairs or for the hallway past it or both?
The stairs.
The stairs, so I can go the other way? Mm-hmm. I want to check out all the publicly accessible areas of this building. It's because it's an old building, 1888, I saw it was built. Mm-hmm.
The judge's office is at the end of the...
So if I keep going that way, it kind of opens up some more?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Looked like it ended right there, so I wasn't sure.
Well, there's a couple of offices down there.
Okay. Okay, cool. All right, thank you.
You're welcome.
Hello, how are you?
I'm just fine.
I don't need any help. I appreciate it, though. And actually, is there anything that you recommend I look at?
Okay, can I ask why?
Yeah, I'm just getting some video of the building. This was built in 1888, is that correct?
Mm-hmm.
So, I like to check out historical public buildings. So, I was just getting some video of it.
Okay. I don't know if we need to let you video inside.
Oh, it's definitely a public, this is a public building, right? So this is a public building and anywhere that's publicly accessible, I have the right to film. And that's
video?
Yes, ma'am, and that's a First Amendment protected activity that the Supreme Court's already ruled on. So I already asked where I couldn't go. I saw signs that said employees only upstairs. I'm not going up there. But anywhere that's public,
yes,
I just wanted to get some pictures, and I'll be on my way. And that's how the law is. That's my rights. I'm not doing anything to anybody.
But you're not going in any of the offices, right?
I mean, if it's a public office, I can. I went in one to ask a lady where I can go, but other than that, I haven't yet. But if it's a public office, like this is a public office, I can walk in here and film right now. If you tried to stop me, it would. I mean, I don't want to go there, but.
Yeah, but we've got personal stuff in here, too.
So kind of how that works. So you work for the public, right? And this is a
I do work for the public.
Okay. So then this is, and this is a public office. So anything, when it comes to public space, if there's something that you want to keep private, then the onus is on you to make sure I don't see it. For example, if I walked in there and you held up someone's personal info and I filmed it, that's not me doing something wrong. That would be you. I'm not saying you would hold it up, but that's what I'm saying. Is so you don't want to keep someone's personal information on your desk where another person of the public can come in and see that. And I'm only going to video what I can see. I'm not going to get behind anyone's desk.
What's the purpose of your video?
This is a historical building. This is a 150-year-old building.
What are you doing with this video?
I usually put them on. I publish them in various places. I've been all over Arkansas.
Define various. If you can sit here and make demands of us, we could also make demands.
I'm not demanding anything. I'm just
saying where you're saying to come in our office, whether we want to allow you to.
Is this your office or is this the public's office?
This office, I am in charge of it.
You're in charge of it.
And I'm in charge.
Okay, and I'm not even asking to come in there, so I don't know why you butted yourself into this conversation.
Yeah, but I asked you, we're here what you're saying.
I was talking to her, and I'll continue talking to her. She was being polite. You weren't. I'm not talking to her anymore.
If you're videoing us,
we need to de-escalate. We don't need to start confrontation. I was being polite, and so was she.
Please do me a favor and stop the video.
No, ma'am. Are you going to violate my rights?
Come right in here.
Absolutely. I'd love to. Let's check this out. Who is this? Thanks for inviting me in.
I did. I had wanted you to sit right there.
Are you detaining me? I can leave right now if I wanted to.
Would you please? We've got stuff out on our desk.
That's on you to make private, ma'am.
Okay, then stand out in the hall.
You just asked me to come in here.
And I'm telling you to stand out in the hall now.
You just asked me to come
in
here.
Would you tell Ricky to come over here? Right now, please.
You guys are making yourself look bad right now. I was being polite. I'm just getting videos of this historical building, and now you want to try to order me around?
But, sir, you're telling me. I'm not going to say nothing else.
What was I telling you? No, what was I telling you? I wasn't telling you anything.
Okay,
I was telling you that I was following the law.
Sit down.
You can't make me do anything.
Well, I can tell you to get out of
You work for the public. No, you can't. This isn't your office. This is the public's office that the taxpayers pay for. I wasn't even going to come in here but to say hi and leave. But you wanted us.
Yes.
You started the conversation. I thought that was cordial between me and you until the other lady started butting
in.
Well,
I asked you if I could help you what you were doing.
So
yes.
I don't see what the issue is.
Do what?
What is his name?
Who are you and what's your name?
My name is Ann Reed, and I'm the administrative assistant in this office.
Hi, Ann. I'm Justin.
Justin.
That's all I'm giving. Thank you.
Then why did she have to give?
Because she works for the public, and I'm a private citizen.
You better leave.
Why is that?
Because you were told to leave. That's why.
This is a public office, sir.
Sir.
What's your name?
You're not giving that.
What is your name?
My name is none of your business.
Do you work for the public? Then it is my business.
The cops are on the way, and
okay.
You're going to make this a problem.
I'm not making anything a problem. Do not touch. That'll be assault charge if you touch my stuff.
Assault is hitting you.
No, it is not. Touching me in any way is assault. And you want to find out?
Yeah, get the heck
out of here. I'm being polite to everybody. You guys are the ones being rude to me. I've been cordial, polite with everybody I've encountered.
Why are you showing like this? Why you show up like this?
What do you mean? I was getting pictures of a historical building and now I'm being bombarded by y'all.
Because you're videoing us.
How am I supposed to get pictures of a historical building without a camera?
Okay, but you don't need to video us.
You came up to me. I wasn't videoing you.
Okay, but I asked you to turn the video off and you wouldn't do it.
I wasn't even trying
Edwin,
to video.
What's going on?
How's it going,
sir?
This
gentleman was out here videoing. He's videoing the courthouse.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I asked him what he needed, if he needed any help, blah, blah, blah.
I told her no, thank you.
And I asked him.
Told her right now.
Yes, sir, no problem.
I asked him why he's videoing the courthouse.
Right.
Because he's videoing. And then he informed me that he was a citizen,
mm-hmm.
and he could come in here and video anything in our offices.
That's not what I
except
said.
Except if we've got public stuff or stuff on our desk.
She's skewing it a little bit, but
whatever.
You can go ahead. Sorry.
But I asked him to quit.
I wasn't even coming in here, ma'am. You asked me to
and
come
he
in
won't
here.
Quit taping us.
She asked me to walk in here. I was in the hallway.
Okay.
And it's all on video.
Don't go back and forth between each other. Okay.
Yeah. Right,
sure. There's already disturbance here. Okay.
I wouldn't call it a disturbance, but sure. Yes, yeah, sir.
It's a disturbance when it's getting loud. It's a disturbance. Maybe one side or two side. It's still a disturbance.
I wasn't being loud. I have it all on video.
Okay. I know you have it all on video. I didn't say you were getting loud. You're turning everything I'm saying around
well,
now.
Well, you just said we were getting loud.
We're going to separate you two, and this is her office, so I'm going to need you to step out here.
No problem.
He told me I couldn't tell.
It's a public office is what I said. She couldn't order me around. She was trying to make me sit down. I said, I'm not going to sit down. I'm not going to. You can't make me do anything. Now, okay, so let me step back a little bit because they all just kind of all jumped on me at once and riled me up a little bit. Me and her were actually having a very polite conversation, and then three other people came in, and then it just kind of got. So this is a historical building. It was built in 1888. I came in, I wanted to get pictures of it. I even asked these ladies back here, hey, where can I go? Where can I not go? I don't want to go anywhere I can.
Right.
They told me, blah, blah, blah. They even said, go down and check out the county judge back here, everything. I walked back here because they said, go down here and check it out.
There's very little on this floor,
and that's
very
what,
little of any of it that's historical anymore because it's all been remodeled.
I didn't know that. Yeah,
you'd have no historical value at this time as far as the structure itself is historical.
And I see that now.
But this is all sheetrock and all that's been done.
Unfortunately, it's not as pretty as
it
once was.
What you would think.
But that's it, man. And I had made it.
Did you introduce yourself and tell what you were
doing? Yeah, yes, sir. I made it to here. And then it just boom, and then they're like, come in here and sit down. And I said, I'll come in here, but I don't know why you guys are being like this to me. And then that gentleman in there was like, well, you need to leave now. He tried to take my phone from me. He put his hands on my property. It's a whole thing.
Yeah.
For what?
Do you want to file a report on any of this?
I would like to make a complaint on those people
we'll
for sure.
For you.
Thank you.
Are you?
Can I get you guys' names? I'm sorry.
I'm Sheriff Ricky Jones.
Sheriff.
Sure. County, and he's Chief Deputy.
Chief Deputy.
Thank you.
Are you done with what you need?
Pretty much. I mean, is there anywhere else that is worth checking out in this building? I think I've seen it all. I've just went from that front door to here.
Like you said, all the inside's really been remodeled.
Yeah.
The exterior is still kind of
the old courtroom is upstairs, but it's full of island cabinets
is there,
and stuff. It's really not a...
Could I ask a favor and have someone show me that? Is it still old? Looking?
Yeah, we'll walk up there.
Really?
Yeah.
Thank you. Yeah, and unfortunately, I didn't get all their names. I'd like to get all their names so I can properly... Thank you. The gentleman that put his hands on my phone specifically. Oh, this has been remodeled too.
Yeah.
It's a little older, though.
Anything like a...
Oh, okay. Okay, I was hoping for something a little cooler. Thank you, though.
The outside of the building is really the neatest look. Are you just like a blogger that does historical stuff?
Yeah.
So there is a, I don't know if it's open, but this museum right here, it's got a bunch of cool historical stuff in it.
This building right here?
Yep, that's a museum. That's like a Perry County Historical Museum.
Is it a public building?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. I'll check that out. Yeah, I'd like to get a couple forms.
I don't know if I got a statement.
I know that I don't. Mine's on my desk where I just...
Are you in a vehicle? Report.
And then I got dropped off.
The sheriff's office is like a block down that way if you want to follow us down there to do a report.
Okay. Before I leave here, I want to make sure I get all their names.
Okay. Can I can give you their
can
names.
Can you... Well, I just want to... I don't want to just... I don't want to take your word for it. That I want to make sure I get all their names on camera so I have it. Can you please walk in there with me and I can get their names? I won't even say anything if you want to start it. I'm not intending to start an argument with anybody.
Who do you know? Who all was in there?
Oh, I can tell you.
All right, so those two ladies are the county judge's secretaries. One of them is Ann Reed, is the older lady's name. And then the lady in the glasses' name is Michelle Parks.
Michelle Parks is
now
in the green shirt.
Huh?
She's in the green shirt, Michelle Parks, with the glasses.
Yes.
Right there? Okay. And then the,
and
other
the
one.
Man is a private individual that doesn't work for the county, that's an insurance salesman. So that was kind of why they wanted.
You're positive on that?
Yes, sir. Okay. Oh, yeah. I've been an employee of the county for about 15 years.
Okay. Okay.
He's definitely not the county judge. The county judge is about my height.
Okay. I just didn't want to find out he was lying and really did work for the public or something.
But yeah, if you want to do a police report, sheriff's office is right down
I'll
here.
I'll walk right over there right now.
It's basically, you see the historical museum. Yeah. The sheriff's office is just on the other side of
that. So did you explain to them that I'm allowed to film in this public building?
Yes. Yes. And the only thing that they had was... they were in a meeting with the insurance agent or whatever, and I said, well, I'll come back and get with the county judge. I don't know where he's at, but I'll call him. But, yeah, I mean, if it's a public space, public building,
okay,
all that, so.
Just want them to understand. All right, cool. Which way is the sheriff? This way? Okay, don't worry. We did not forget. Off camera, Sheriff Ricky Jones did give me that third lady's name. Karen Quattlebaum, who works for the treasurer's office. Also, to put into my police statement, he gave me the insurance salesman's name who tried to grab my phone, Steve Inzer. Thank you. Cool. Thanks, sir. All right, well, I'm going to go see what else I can find in town. I appreciate you guys being professional.
The only other thing we really have in town, Perryville City Hall, they have a water department and a police department there.
Well, thanks again, man.
Yes, sir.
It's good to meet you guys. Appreciate you.
It's October 10th, 2024, and Morrilton, Arkansas Police Officer Joe Roche, or Rock, is following Perry County Chief Deputy Edwin Johnson and Perry County Sheriff Ricky Don Jones after they leave a local restaurant together and seem to be swerving back and forth between the mustard and the mayonnaise.
Yeah, I don't know, man. He might be drunk.
Oh, there you go.
Oh, yeah.
There you
back over that line. 113 dispatch. Yeah, I'm probably going to, well, no, I'll approach from this side. Hello.
Hello.
I'm Patrolman Roach, Multiple Police Department. Reason I stopped you, man, you're back and forth all over the road.
I'm with Dawson.
I got you. How much you had drink tonight?
We bought a bucket. One bucket.
I was just wondering because you got the beer open there.
No, that's old. Okay. I've been spitting in it.
Okay. All right. Hop out here for me, bud. I'll come back here. Alright, so you said you've only had like three?
Yeah.
Alright, just hang out right there for me. Are you law enforcement or anything?
I'm Chief Deputy of Perry County.
Chief Deputy of Perry County?
That's a sheriff, wouldn't it?
Okay, all right. So? So how much have you had to drink again?
I've had about three, maybe four. We bought a bucket.
I got you, all right. Are you willing to do any tests for me?
I guess I can.
Are you willing to? Here's the deal, man. If you're chief deputy, you know you're not supposed to be drinking and driving.
I understand. Okay. I understand.
You know, I can't just not do my job because it's a PGR.
Right.
Okay?
I understand. That's why I didn't say
I know. Well, I saw the card in your hand. That's why I was asking, okay?
Yeah.
You know, I'm willing to try to work with you any way I can, but again, I still got a job that I got to do, okay? Mm-hmm. And you know that.
Yeah, I understand.
So, are you willing to do some tests?
Well, I don't know at this point with three, I don't know, and I haven't written a DWI in 20 years.
I got you.
But I'm not drunk. I can take some of your tests, but I just had knee surgery not 2 years ago, but
okay.
I can't stand on my...
Are you willing to do HCN?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Give me 1 second, then. All right. If you will, just remove your hat for me, okay? Place your feet together, arms directly to your side. You see the tip of my finger?
Yeah.
All right, with your eyes and your eyes only, without moving your head, I want you to follow the tip of my finger. You understand?
Yeah. You got me nervous.
Well, you the police. You shouldn't be that nervous, right?
Oh, I understand, but I get nervous when they get behind me.
Don't move your head, okay?
Yeah.
Even cops get nervous when other cops are around. Cops know they make people nervous, and they love it. They use it. Keep watching.
I can't turn it that far.
Are you willing to try the other test, the walk and turn one like sand, anything like that? Well, yeah. I understand that you said that you just had surgery and everything. That's why I'm asking.
I mean, like I said, I've had 3 beer in the last hour and a half, 2 hours.
Give me 1 second, okay? Chief Deputy, Sheriff.
Yep.
I'm pretty positive. Chief Deputy's driving. Pretty positive, bro. He said he's only had 3 beer, but then he went from might have been 3, maybe 4. There's open containers inside the vehicle. He already made the comment. Dispatch 10-4. It was kind of a toss up on whether or not he was even going to take the test, because he was like, I don't think I'm drunk, but he's like, I haven't done DWI in 20 years and all that. He talks about being nervous and all that. Here's the thing. Can't just not do the job because he's just I've explained that to him. And then even he started moving his head while doing that, said, HGN. And I was like, don't move your head. He's like, I'm just nervous. I'm like, you're the police. You shouldn't be nervous. Really. So I'm going to go back up there now. I'm going to get my dad. Yeah, I just wanted you over here just in case.
And get that.
So. All right, Mr. Johnson. So are you willing to try to do the walk and turn one leg stand? It's up to you.
I can try.
All right. What I want you to do is I want you to take your left foot, put it on that line, go ahead and do that now. Take your right foot, heel to toe, in front of your left foot. I want you to stay in that position until I tell you to begin. Do you understand?
Okay.
You may begin.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine.
Okay. Right. You turn and face me. You're good. Yeah, you're good. Right. You're willing to do the one leg stand, correct?
I'll try.
Right. I'm gonna wait until these cars pass.
Got me leaning here, but
I got you. Anyways, I'm gonna ask you to pick up a foot, either foot, doesn't matter.
Okay.
You're gonna pick it up approximately 6 inches off the ground, keeping your foot parallel to the ground. You're gonna count out loud. 1001, 1002, 1003, and you may begin.
One, two, three, four, five. I can't do it.
Alright.
Foot and knees hurting, I can't do it.
I got you. Would you be willing to blow in a PBT for me?
I don't know. I really don't. I hate to argue with a police officer.
No, I understand.
I hate to argue with a police officer. I had a beer right before we left. I drank about half a beer and set it on the table. So,
okay.
I hate to do that.
Well, you know, a bucket and a steak.
Huh?
A bucket and a steak.
A bucket and a steak is what I've had.
Okay.
We had a bucket and a steak and listened to Jason Campbell play because he's from Perry County.
I got you. All right. Again, I'm just asking, would you be willing to?
I don't know, man.
We're just trying to gauge where you're at, man. You know as well as we do.
Oh, I know. Yeah. I know, but like I said, I drank a half a beer before I walked, out the door, which is right over there, I don't think I should. I mean, for a little bit anyway.
So you don't want to You don't want to do that?
I don't want to do a PBT. I don't, and I know it's not admissible in court. I just...
Okay. Well, here's the thing, okay? I've done all these tests. Mm. I do believe that there is enough to arrest you for DWI on the test. Okay? Give me 1 second, though. Let me talk to my sergeant. I think we both know that that's not a pass or fail test, okay?
What do you mean it's not a pass or fail
test? It's not a pass or fail test. SFSTs, you look for clues. It's not a pass or fail test.
Yeah, how many clues did he fail on? You have to, it's okay. A pass or fail.
It's not pass or fail.
It's not a pass or fail, man. That's...
So many clues is a fail.
There is so many clues. There's
so many clues gives you a percentage to what you're looking for, but again, it's not a pass or fail.
I don't have any interest in arguing.
And I'm not trying to argue with you. He made
I mean,
a comment.
If you feel like I need to get a ride or whatever, that's fine with me. Somebody to drive, whatever, that's, I'm okay with that. I don't want a problem with y'all at all. We bought a steak each and a bucket of beer.
Well, so here's the thing, okay? I'm trying to give you the professional courtesy, mm-hmm. okay? Typically, on a DWI, I would not call my sergeant over here and discuss all this with him. If this was anyone else, I wouldn't. If he was over here, it's because he just came over here on his own.
Right.
I've asked him to come over here.
Okay.
So let me go speak with him real quick, okay?
The only reason he's wanting to blow on PBT is to see if you're under. Because he doesn't, I'm going to be honest with you, I'm his supervisor, he doesn't use a PBT on his DWIs most of the time because he's confident in his SFSTs.
Right.
Is what it is. But give us a sec. I'll call him. You go up there.
No, I'll call him real quick if you'll go up there. Hey, buddy. So, I am out with Chief Deputy and Sheriff of Perry County. Chief Deputy's driving and like 99% positive he is DWI. I've already done HGN or all SFSTs. It's just kind of, I was asking Alvy what he thought and everything. He won't blow in a PBT. Asking what he thought, and he said to call you and see what you think because you're probably going to hear about it anyways. But I wanted to check with you first to try to do that professional courtesy and everything for them. I got you. Well, like I said, I wanted to check with you first, and Alvy kind of told me to check with you first too before we went off. Alvy's pretty much was telling me the same thing you were, but he did say maybe just check with you first. All right, then.
I mean, I don't know if y'all ever been in this situation, but we have a few times, and it's not fun.
It's a pretty shitty situation, man.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, I understand, but I mean, I wouldn't be buying Wilfus drunk. I'm not.
So, here's the deal. He got 66 clues on your eyes, 3 clues on your walk and turn. 2 is what you're looking for.
And then 1 leg stand. I mean, you didn't do it, but 5 seconds. But
right, but
automatically
I
got.
I can't do 1 leg stand even when I'm instructing
it. I'm just, I wouldn't have got in my truck if I was a dime.
I promise you, I can do it right now, flying colors, and I'm very overweight, man.
I can't, not with my bad ankles.
I promise you, I wouldn't have crawled in the truck if I... I'm not that guy. We've had a steak and 3 beer each. And I say that, we had a bucket.
Did you just put a dip or a piece of gum or anything in your mouth?
I've got Zen.
Zen? Okay.
I threw it out.
Well, I mean, you just threw it out, so I'm not going to ask you to blow in a PBT again. The thing is like, I'm trying to give you as much courtesy as I can.
Right.
Okay? But the thing is DWIs are DWIs, okay? We both know that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? I've talked to my sergeant. I've called my assistant chief to see how to go about handling this, and it's pretty much one of them things, DWIs are DWIs.
Right. Right.
Okay? So,
I mean, there is no professional courtesy on the DWI.
Man, I'm trying to do everything I can, okay?
It is what it is.
So, man, right now, I'm going to place you under arrest for DWI, okay?
Can I throw this hat in the truck?
Absolutely.
In my pocket knife?
Yeah, go ahead.
and get my wallet.
You good? You'll come back here with me. No gun or anything on you?
No.
Okay.
Hey.
Yep.
Can you call somebody to get my truck?
Yep. Yep. Do you think that you're over the limit? Or do we need to call?
We drank a bucket of beer. We had 3 E's. So, I mean, if you think he's doing it, yeah, I don't need to drive.
All right. Do you want to call someone to come pick up his vehicle?
Absolutely. Yep. Let me grab my phone.
Yep. Pretty much what you told me is what Trent told me. Man, I just don't feel right taking someone to jail for DWI, but because he's law enforcement. You see what I'm saying? So like if I was drinking and driving and was over the limit and I got pulled over, I'd probably go to jail.
So props to Moralton Officer Joe Roche, or Rock. Sorry, dude. I'm not sure how to pronounce your last name. But two thumbs up for not letting the thin blue line alter your decision-making skills when pulling over another thin blue line gang member. Good job, dude. Now, the Chief Deputy Edwin Johnson, or ex-Chief Deputy, I should say, he resigned that following Monday. But guess who didn't resign? The sheriff. Now, I know the sheriff wasn't driving, but he was riding passenger. And he knew damn well the guy that was driving was drinking, because they were drinking together. So doesn't that compromise the sheriff's integrity just as much as the Chief Deputy's? Wouldn't you think that the sheriff is just as much in the wrong for allowing it to happen as the Chief Deputy was? So Sheriff Ricky Don Jones actually doubles down and says that they're both innocent. He goes on his personal Facebook and writes a post that says that Edwin was not drunk, he wasn't even tipsy, and that he disagrees with the arrest. He says, I've always been on the law enforcement officer side, but those guys had their minds made up when they stopped us, and I have no doubt that Edwin will be found not guilty. So how can you continue to be a sheriff in your county? And I'm kind of in a rock between a rock and a hard place here, because he's actually a good dude, but apparently not, because he treats himself and his colleagues differently than the people that elected him. Because how are you going to go out now and arrest anybody else in your county for a DWI for the rest of your career? You will be a hypocrite. You can't do it. You can't pull over anyone that's been drinking and say shit, because you yourself did it and are pleading your case that you shouldn't get in trouble. You're still sheriff. The guy that was actually driving resigned, and you think that he shouldn't get in trouble either. By the way, he's running for re-election in 2026.